And bonjour à tous. I am Alessandra Bagnato from Softeam Research Development Department. And I thank you, OW2 and our forum, to have invited me here to speak to you all about the OSSMETER project. OSSMETER is an FP7 project funded by the European Commission to improve the state of the art in the automatic measurement of open source software. So we are very happy to be here today with this audience to let you know what we have done in these 2 years of work, because actually it is the second year of the project that is going to finish this month. So selecting an open source software is our challenge. And what we know is that is, and that you also know, is that this is a real task. We spend a lot of time to do that. We actually have trouble because this is things that require expertise, that can make us error prone, and that it's a stress test sometime. And also, for selecting open source software, we have basically all the same needs. We want just to see that our open source software is adopted by many people. It is strong with its community. And it is backed by some company, it is backed by a strong community of developers, is used by other people, and it has been around for a while. We also would like to monitor our open source software after our selection, and we want to monitor how it is going, the company behind this software. We want to monitor if the open source developers are still in the company, if they have not lost interest in our open source software. And we want to be warned if something happens to this open source software that we have selected. That is where we are placed with OSSMETER. Our vision is to develop a platform that will support this kind of needs. And so we want just to help to discover and compare open source software that is in the market. And what are our sources of information? We are taking advantage of everything that is in issue a bug tracker. We want to see the source code repository and all the metadata. And we are interested in looking at the communication channels like news group and forum. We have meta models behind our work. And these meta models are storing all the relevant information of open source software. And we have working with language agnostic tool and some language specific tool to do code analysis, which is very important in the context of open source because we are very interested in the quality of the code. And we are also doing natural language processing and text mining. That allows us basically to have sentiment analysis on our communication channels and so to see how the people is feeling about our code. For language agnostic analysis, we want to integrate what is the state of the art and have tailored metrics for the source code. For what regards the backtracking communication analysis, we are going to understand on the basis of the language that is used within the forum, what are the feelings and what are the emotions that are felt by the developers. And so if developers are angry or if developers are not satisfied, this information is coming out of our analysis. And then what we expect, and that you will see soon, since as I say to you, we are almost at the end of the project, we expect an extensible cloud-based platform dot where you will be able to monitor and select your open source software. The platform will allow storage and analysis and will be available as a service, but it will also be possible to install it in-house. And who will be interested in this? Will be, of course, the developer of open source software and developers and project manager in general, and of course the funding body that can be interested. This is our platform. You can see the project analysis and management, metrics and connector, and it is very, very extensible. We will release all the guidelines to extend this. So, of course, we have not every possible metrics, but the platform is thought to be extensible. And in here is some example of the front end for our metrics. And You can see in here the line of code, how they are going through time. We are actually monitoring the base of information that we have. And we can compare, so we can compare in this screen. We are comparing subversive ante Tomcat, but of course we can have comparison for tools that are of interest for us. And who are the partners in this project? The Open Group is the coordinator, then Technalia, then Softeam, that is the company that I represent, Uninova and Uniparallel Innovation, that are providing case study to evaluate the result of OSSMETER. And in this particular context, Softeam will evaluate in the context of the Modelio open source modeling tool that you can find offline at modelio.org. I will give you the link. Then as academic partner, we have CWE, that has expertise in code analysis, University of Manchester, that is for the sentiment analysis which I talked about, then University of York and University of Aquila for model-driven engineering. We are in this context of European collaboration, very happy collaborating with all the projects that have been involved in open source, in particular beyond the one that have been already mentioned, Marcos, Riscos, and the Pros, that are working together between their beginning. And then in here you see an example of the platform that will be soon online. The live demo will be online at the end of November, and all the code behind the platform will be realized under APL at the end of April, that coincide with the end of the project. And these are my contact details. You can follow OSSMETER on Twitter, that is at OSSMETER. And if you have any questions, you can just ask me now or contact me later using my contact details. Thank you.
OSSMETER would be a platform available in EPL.
Yes.
And where is it? Where can we download it from?
We are starting up the setup of a server based, and from there you will have the link. Probably anche from also from the OSSMETER website directly. So it will be plenty of information, and we will be published it everywhere. And also with our collaboration with the other project, we all will give you the link, and we'll be very happy of you testing it. Thank you.
Tell me. So I was very entertained by the idea of doing sentiment analysis for evaluating those projects. I can imagine that actually it can help a lot. But I was also thinking, well, now I started to think about Linus Torvalds, who probably everybody knows, he's very good as an architect, at least Linux is a very good project. I think we can all agree on that.
Yes.
But he's also very rude. And if you look at the Linux kernel mailing list, I think there are quite often some flamers and so on. So I wonder, I mean, maybe this tells us something about the personality of the community that develops the things, but sometimes, I don't know, I'm just curious about how much is that predictive about the quality of the project that is there.
Well, let's say that gives you some information on the emotion that are behind this community. So it's true that when one is happy, one doesn't always write it that in a forum.
Yeah.
One is more often writing that one is very sad because nothing works, so it needs help. So, but I think that we can gather some information because, for example, we noticed the thank you messages in the community. Actually, when people, we are monitoring that. And I remember that when we were doing the first evaluation, I selected my favorite thank you message. And actually, from the thank you message, you can really see if the community is reacting well. And actually, somebody is sad, somebody is angry, but in the end, you make it happy with some help. Of course, if this person waits 2 years to have the answer, maybe it does. You don't have any thank you. But I mean, thank you. Yeah.
For example, for Eclipse,
which really focuses more on documentation and yet in open source software systems we know that the documentation is very useful. Most developers don't present documentation. So will the new system you are developing be also highly dependent on documentation, or can be, it can work with less documentation online?
Let's say that we are focusing more on the Forge. This project focuses more on the Forge. We can monitor Git, SVN, and documentation. We rely on the help of other projects. For example, for licenses, that is a very strong point because licenses have documentation. I have lawyer behind, and I have heard a very nice talk yesterday on I am a lawyer. We should be very careful on everything like that. And no, we don't do that. But for example, like I point you to Marco's project for that. We have been strongly collaborating on that. They have a license analyzer in their project. And well, that would be interesting. I can give you the link of the person that you can contact. That is the good things of collaborating European project. So thank you.